we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a self made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shout out to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why, we ain't never got a self made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Stunned like no one stunned. She curved me back then, came back, so I swung her. I ain't going out like no sucker. No sucker. Had to let it burn like Usher. Gave a rush for it.
Today, from London, England, it's the NFL International Series on EA Sports. We'll see Tom Brady and the Jacksonville Jaguars taking on Trey Lance and the Miami Dolphins.
It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Today we've got a Week 6 matchup for you here between the Miami Dolphins and the Jacksonville Jaguars. This will be fielded inside the 5. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. So here's the first drive now for the Jags. They will be led out by their now 44-year-old quarterback playing in his 22nd NFL season. Unbelievable. The great Tom Brady.
Now, the meeting we had with him this week, that's one of the briefer ones we've ever had, isn't it?
He wasn't too happy after last week.
Not happy. Really determined to play a whole lot better, and he really can't play a whole lot worse. He's got to go out and show the team that the goods that he exhibited early are still there. Otherwise, he could lose the confidence that they have in him.
And hoping to get rid of that interception bug. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Here's a give to Lindsay. And he'll be tackled just past the 35 at the 36. That's going to be a 6-yard gain. It leaves him with 3rd down and just 1 yard to go. This defense for the Dolphins, they were terrific a week ago in that victory over Tampa Bay, Charles.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass, a run. What will they do? We're about to find out. 4th down.
I'm laughing because I'm not so sure I would have made this call. I'm not so sure I would have said, yeah, let's go ahead and get this one, especially at this point of the game. But give him credit. He had a feeling and carried it through.
Yeah, that's one where you think, okay, if you're down 2 minutes left, the ball's near midfield, you go for it. But at this stage, at that part of the field, but like you said, it worked. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back 5. Now it's Lindsay. He'll give the tackle to Anthony Walker.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. Was that 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. They fake the handoff. Now Brady. And his throw is incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone, and there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
On 3rd and long, it's Brady. Man open, that's Henry Ruggs. And he'll be marked down deep on Miami's side of the field. A big play that time for Jacksonville. So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for 1st and 10. Into the red zone, it's Brady. He gets it to Thomas. A gain of six there on first. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
How about this? They'll try the option. Left side. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a third down. Shotgun now for Brady. Flush to his right. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Only able to get back a yard for his efforts, and that leads us to fourth down.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. They'll run with Lindsay. He pushes forward from maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
One more time with Lindsay, and a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, and now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Tyler Boyd, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Jaguars drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. Boswell good with the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. So now here are the Dolphins getting set for their first drive. They'll be led out by the third overall pick in April's draft, the rookie from North Dakota State, Trey Lance. Lance now on first down. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there. It's second down. Throwing now is Lance. He's got Njoku over the middle. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. So, Charles, take nothing away from this young man under center, because I know people think he's got a very bright future in this league, but I have to figure the defensive coordinators love the thought of squaring off against a rookie quarterback.
And especially if they have guys they can put together a game plan with that's going to confuse, disguise a lot of coverage, make this kid think a little bit. Because in college, he's seen a lot of things. Let's not get it wrong here. But at the same time, in the NFL, you can do so much more because of the athletes you have, because of their football IQ. And don't forget, you're going to throw a couple extra rushers at him as well. See if he can handle the pressure when those guys come at him.
A big boot that time, 57 yards the official distance. And it'll be Jaguar football as they take over deep in their own territory. On first and 10, it's Lindsay. And not much there at all. He's up only to about the 16-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
And he'll take this one up over the 20 to the 21-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about 4 more for a first. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. The Jaguars on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. Now Brady. And that will be incomplete. Kenny Moore that time there on the coverage. On fourth down, on is Corey Bohorquez to punt. Only 2 punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And it'll be Dolphin football. So Miami coming out for their second drive. So the crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting.
And he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. He couldn't get rid of it. He winds up losing a yard. It's 2nd down. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
And the pressure gets to him again. Credit the sack to Shaquem Griffin.
So, Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
Throwing is Lance on 3rd down. And he'll only get this to about the 35. Well short of the line to gain. Decent gain on the scramble of 6, but now it's 4th. The Dolphins will send out the punter now as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. And this one hits at the 3 and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. So here are the Jaguars to take over on offense. They were losers a week ago to Tennessee, but they're on top right now as they come up here 1st and 10. Now a play fake, Brady. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. A fight for it, and this is caught. What a catch. A big play that time through the air. 34 yards. And he has now hit number 500. Charles, that is his 500th NFL career catch.
Definitely worthy of applause, but I remember when 500 meant you were going to the Hall of Fame. Nowadays, in today's football, 500 puts you on the path. A significant number.
That throw by Brady, incomplete.
No sense risking anything there on 1st down. Even though he's still in the pocket, he had a receiver out to his side, so just put that in a spot where the only people who could make a play on it are the trainers and the coaches.
Well done.
He'll get only a couple down to the 44. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Throwing is Brady on 3rd down. Oh, this will be incomplete. The rush gets home just as he was letting that go. That could have been worse. Instead, it's 4th down. And the Jaguars send out their punter as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. The Dolphins offense now working their way back onto the field. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a 1st down now. Now Lance. It's caught by Mike Evans. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard. Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line. 2nd and a yard. They fake the handoff. Now Lance going up top. And that is intercepted on the sideline. Wait, no. They'll say no, it was caught out of bounds. So this is just an incompletion here. They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first.
Yeah, they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last two possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Lance looking to throw it. Now a swing pass. It's Edwards-Helaire. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion. And that'll bring up second down. Here's Lance. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. And they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. Now Brady bounces forward on the jet sweep. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. This defense not fooled one bit on that touch pass.
And this has become one of those kind of in vogue plays, you know, kind of like the shuffle pass was a few years ago. This one never got off the ground, but you understand why a lot of teams are running it. These wide receivers, a lot of them, they run like running backs with the ball in their hands.
And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. A big connection on that one. 36 yards.
The timing was absolutely true as he caught it working across the field. Plenty of space for him to roam. But notice how he keeps his head on a swivel, looking for defenders who may crop up out of nowhere. That turned into a big play.
Play action. Now it's Brady. Oh, bottled up. It's out. It's loose. We hear them discuss red zone efficiency a lot, CD, and they almost gave that one up in the red zone. Luckily, they'll have another shot.
And you and I both know that every offensive coordinator, play caller in the league, they take particular delight in their red zone calls because those are the payoff ones. But you can't call a play if your team doesn't have the ball. Got to secure it.
Down to the 3, but now this is 3rd and goal. They'll try to punch it in with Fournette. They push forward, but I don't think it's enough. He's going to be about a yard short. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. A field goal would make it a 2-score game, but they're going to go aggressive. They're going to try this thing on 4th and goal. They'll go with a big back for that. And this time he is in.
Yes.
Leonard Fournette with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Jaguars are able to widen their lead. Extra point put through by Boswell. And it's now 14-0. A drive that time of 6 plays. And the man who finished it off with a run into the end zone, Leonard Fournette. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. Donovan Peoples-Jones now from the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. He's got to dig deep here, doesn't he? Team's losing. He's not playing well either.
And they always tell you, don't press. You'll make things a little bit worse. But in this particular situation, you try and heighten your play a little bit. So far, he's thrown one interception. He wants to balance that off with at least one touchdown pass in order to get his team back moving forward.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Lance now to throw. And he'll look underneath here for Edwards-Helaire. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9. Lance trying to urge his offense to go quickly. Airing it out deep for Smith. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. The Dolphins will send out the punter now as he's on here to punt it away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And problems spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. Tom Brady leads the offense out for their next possession. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
They'll try again from the 20 on second and 10. On play action, now Brady. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Play action, it's Brady. This is caught, it's Boyd. Now a timeout called with 3 seconds to go, and of course they're in field goal range in the final seconds of this first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. Spotted at the left hash, this from 45. Boswell's kick is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we reach half. And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently we're going to get right back to it. As they say here in London, all to play for as we are back underway in the second half. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out comes the Dolphins now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. To throw, it's Lance. And that's going to be caught by Peoples-Jones. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone. That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Here's Lance to throw it. Escaping the pressure right. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. On second down, a run with Edwards-Helaire. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40.
despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. And some room to run now. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. What makes a draw play like that successful?
Well, we did see where he made the first wave miss, and that was a big part of it. But a lot of it is just being actors back there, making the defense think it's going to be a pass.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw to Evans on the slant. Touchdown! Mike Evans, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Dolphins are able to cut into this lead as they score on the opening drive of the second half. Extra point tacked on by Lambeau. And the lead is trimmed down to 10. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. This one fielded at the 5. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Here comes the Jags offense now. Time for their first possession of half number 2. And they were terrific in the first half, built up a sizable lead, and it's just been cut into a bit following the opening drive score on the other side. But this is a unit that has to be itching to get the football again.
You could say that again. They've got to be pretty eager because, let's face it, they've had to sit through halftime, then sit on the sidelines and watch that drive. So you can bet that they're saying, let's get on with this. We got to go out there and get some more points.
On second down, right back to Lindsey. And now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6. Here's Brady to throw. He gets this one to Boyd. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there? Yeah. Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he's gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch. Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. On second down now, it's Lindsey. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line.
Yeah, once more, strong running. Excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
Brady now on first down. Eluding the pressure. And a big loss here as he's taken down. In on the sack, the former Buckeye, Tyquan Lewis.
Well, we knew this guy wasn't especially fleet of foot, but he tried to conjure up some escapability, but there was no way he was getting away on that one.
Now this one from about 2 counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long. Another try after the first down sack. Brady. He completes it to Beckham. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a third down. Throwing now is Brady. Being chased out left. And he's gonna go down. He sacked back at the 24. Tyler Lancaster able to get in there and drop him behind the line. They've been brilliant, perfect on fourth down so far. 3 for 3, and they're gonna try again here. Brady to throw for it on fourth down. And he's got it. It's Thomas. For a Jacksonville touchdown. Logan Thomas his second touchdown on the season. And the Jaguars add 6 to their lead. Boswell good with the extra point. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Miami set to take over. They did what they had to do to start this third quarter. Went down, got the touchdown to cut the lead, but the matching touchdown a moment ago, and we're right back where we started at halftime.
Yeah, you're exactly right, partner. They had a little bounce in their step after scoring that first touchdown, but the defense gave one up, and that's the problem right now. Can they get better play from their defense while they continue to score on offense?
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. Shotgun now for Lance. Looking for Evans, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 34. And this one will be brought back to the 22. The rookie was trying to push it downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
On 2nd and 12, Brady. That might be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a 3rd down. The Jaguars on 3rd down. They've converted a 1/3 of their opportunities, 3 for 9. This is 3rd down and 12. And they're going to get him down well short of the first, as he can only get this to about the 19. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll bring up a 4th down.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
They'll go for it. It's Brady. And this will be caught inside the 10. What a grab. The passing game continues to be their friend. Even with a stable lead here in the 4th, Charles, they're going back to that well.
Yeah, with their overall philosophy, you know that they trust their quarterback. He's been able to throw it well. They continue to throw these safe passes. Who can blame them?
That gets them 3 yards closer here as it brings up 2nd and goal. They'll go again with Lindsey. And this time they were ready for him, as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up 3rd down.
Brent, that's clearly a running situation when you're up in the 4th quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Flushed out right. And he takes this down to about the 2 before going out of bounds. 5 yards that time out of the scramble. But now they're looking at a 4th down situation. They'll run for it with Fournette. And he's not going to get in. They stop him at the 1. Leonard Fournette denied on 4th and goal. And the Dolphins celebrate their goal line stand. So we were looking at each other up here in the booth when they went for that, saying, oh, wow, talk about trying to add insult to injury.
Some teams are just like that. You know, some philosophies, some coaches are like, look, when I got a chance to put some more points on the board, I don't care what the situation, I'm going to do it. And they're also the same coaches, as a general rule, that if someone does it to them, you won't hear people protest out of them. That's just who they are.
8 yards the tally on that 1st down run. Here's 2nd and 2. Lance going to throw. That's his running back, Edwards-Helaire. And he gets this one just shy of the 35 to the 34.
I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
To throw again on second down. Lance. He's got Njoku, his big tight end.
I know I spent a lot of time talking about how tight ends in a lot of cases now are pumped up wide receivers, but they're still big people. He used that frame right there to absorb a really big hit on him and held on to the ball.
Flush to his right. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a hole. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down. Looking to throw. Lance. Powerful running.
Not sure how you feel about it, but to me, I think we're seeing it in front of our eyes. This league continues to change. Look at the moves you ordinarily get from a running back from the quarterback position.
Yeah, that's like a Le'Veon Bell type move right there, but you're exactly right. The game's kind of evolving in that way, isn't it?
Yeah, I think the quarterback is rapidly becoming an extra running back as well.
On first down, Lance over the middle to Evans. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Lance now on first down. He'll find his running back, Edwards-Helaire. Looking to throw again on second down. Lance, he'll get that complete to Albert O. And he is out of bounds, looks like right at the 15. That catch good for 5. It's third down. Again, it's Lance. He'll swing this one out to Edwards-Helaire. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. Back to throw again. Oh, the ball is out. Edwards-Helaire lost it. And the Jags grab it. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. He's at the 40. Past the 20. And that might just cement it. A return for a late touchdown.
Well, there's just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking it into the end zone. And you know they could have taken a knee there, but they decided to play this one all the way out. And I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee now, we're actually showing you disrespect that way, like taking pity on you. They're not about to do that to their opponent.
Extra point put through by Boswell. And the lead is now 24. So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. Peoples-Jones going to elect to bring this one out. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down officially at the 21. Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. Remember, they have won 3 straight, but getting to 4 straight does not appear to be in the cards as they are in a big fourth quarter hole. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. After the sack on first down, Lance, he's going to let it fly. And he's going to be intercepted for the 3rd time thus far. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now 3 interceptions in this ballgame.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's a guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Brady going to look to throw. And he will find his man Ruggs. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
Well, this is an awfully tough route to defend in man coverage because he lines up on the right and then runs a crossing route back to the other side of the field. So as a defender, you're not only trailing him the whole way, you're also looking out for your own guys to make sure you don't get yourself picked off. And then you can't catch up in time to prevent the completion.
Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. So this will be a...